Today, we're going to be comparing the macOS graphics API Metal with the Windows 10 API DirectX. Please note, all these games shown today have been played on a 2018 15-inch MacBook Pro and are playing at the same graphical settings, i.e. a resolution of 1920 by 1080. The quality preset is set to medium, VSync is off, motion blur is off, and anti-aliasing is set to off. Anyway, let's begin with our first game, Rise of the Tomb Raider. This game and many others in this video offer a benchmark feature, which will demonstrate how this game performs on your system. Rise of the Tomb Raider shows what Macs are truly capable of when it comes to playing demanding games that are taxing on the CPU and require more and more CPU cycles for exciting gameplay. The overall frame rate here is 40.85 FPS. Under macOS using the Metal API, whilst under Windows 10 using DirectX 11, it receives an overall frame rate of 45.06 FPS. Windows 10 is slightly better, but I'm super impressed with how well optimized this game is for macOS. Next up, we have the racing game F1 2017. Using its benchmark feature, we are able to see its average frame rate is 54 FPS, whilst Windows 10 sees an average frame rate of 73 FPS. Whilst the macOS frame rate is lower, it is still not bad, and this game is perfectly playable around 50 to 60 FPS. Coming up next, we have the, what I would call, infamous Mac game, Fortnite. Under macOS, the game sees around 85 FPS when just walking around and doing whatever you want, and 75 FPS when in more action-packed environments. Under Windows 10, it generally receives around 110 FPS. I don't know why the macOS operating system receives such a lower FPS, but Fortnite has always had optimization issues for the macOS version, as Epic Games don't seem to focus much of their time towards our platform right now. Next, we have Deus Ex Mankind Divided. This game is incredibly demanding, as macOS only receives around 27 FPS and Windows 10 receives 31.1 FPS. Still, it's a great feat that Feral Interactive were able to port this game to our system, and if I played it in low settings, it is perfectly playable. Moving on, we have Definity Original Sin 2. Under macOS, it runs at around 50 FPS, while on Windows, it receives an average frame rate of 58 frames per second. Next up, we have Total War WarHAMMER 2. WarHAMMER 2 is very taxing with so much going on at one time. Using its benchmark feature, we can see that running under macOS, it receives an average frame rate of 28.5 FPS, whilst under Windows 10, we're looking at 29.4 FPS, so there's not really much difference there. But yeah, a very taxing game. Playing it on low, it would be more playable. Our last game is Book of the Dead, which you might remember it was shown back at WWDC 2018. This is a free interactive demo by Unity. It can be used to demonstrate the power of your Mac when it comes to gaming, and also the possibilities offered by using Unity's 2018 new scriptable render pipeline. So this demo is using real-time lighting and complex post-processing effects. Running it on my MacBook Pro, we're seeing an average frame rate of 15 under Windows and 20 under macOS. Now, that's not a great frame rate, but it's just to see what is possible. If I have a Blackmagic eGPU connected, I can receive about 47 frames per second. If you want to get this demo, you can download it from the link in the description, but it is quite complicated to download and set up. So let me know if you want a tutorial, and I am willing to do that. So what can we take from all this? I believe the gap between performance under macOS and Windows is becoming smaller as more and more developers are porting their games to Mac with the Metal API. And OpenGL is soon to be deprecated under macOS, which means Metal is clearly the future of gaming on Mac, whether or not if we like it or developers like it. But what do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching. I'll talk to you guys later. Bye-bye.